Lentils. You hear me?
Yo, bro. Yo, an example of Bob Cousy in the modern day is Scott Skiles, honestly. That's his equivalent to the
I don't know who that is,
but that's not Bob Cousy.
I mean, so just when I say there is no equivalent, because white players had to match up with an abundant amount of other players, bro. He's matching up against other white plumbers, bro. Like, it's not the same. Scott Skiles scoring in any era other than the 50s is more impressive because the competition is just higher because they allowed more than just white people to play. It's not the same. It's just not.
That and is I don't, fact. That is the fact.
In all seriousness aside, like all jokes aside, I dead ass don't even know how much innovation Bob Cousy truly did outside of him just being the first person like to just do it, if that makes sense. Because like as soon as Oscar Robertson and Jerry West and them came in the league, like they were already leaps and bounds better than fucking Bob Cousy. Normally if you're innovating, it takes a while for people to kind of catch on to what you're doing because you're just leaps, you're head and shoulder better than everybody else. But when it became more commonplace for black players to be in the league, bro, the standard was set so high that other players came in the league was already smoking this nigga. Already smoking this nigga.
But he wasn't in his prime. That's not his fault. He was in his Bob Cousy.
What do you mean?
He was in his prime when they started coming in.
I don't – he had, like, 3 or 4 years left in the NBA when –
Yeah, come Oscar on, man. Three or more? Come on. He wasn't Bob Cousy for real.
I know you're joking, but even if you just look at the numbers, like, Oscar Robertson, his rookie year, was already averaging a triple-double. He was already leaps and bounds better than any year of Bob Cousy. You can literally get the best version of Bob Cousy with his points, rebounds, assists, and field goal percentage, and Oscar Robertson was already outdoing that in his rookie season.
Bro, but what Mad Dog says, we can't compare eras like that. You feel me?
No, they were in the same era. Bob Cousy literally was leading the league in assists. Bob Cousy was leading the league in assists with only a 7 assists a game. That's like the first, the lowest or second lowest, or one of the lowest bars ever set in NBA history to lead the league in assists.
He created the
bro. But before you know, they let everyone into the league. Who was Bob Cousy? Like, you're right. I'm a troll. I can't even do it no more, bro. Bob Cousy is fucking weak.
literally, as soon as Oscar came into the NBA, he changed the standard of leading the league in assists from 7 to fucking like 10 to 10 to 11. Yeah, you got to be double digits. So as soon as it was more common for black people to play basketball, bro, the standard changed immediately. Just like that, it just changed. Bro, come on, now. As soon as they were letting it was more commonplace, Bill Russell and Wilt Chamberlain are coming in dominating niggas. Just like that. Like, that's not a coincidence.
Bro, they didn't even track steals until, like, Bob Cousy's been out of the league for 10 years.
Bro, did you see? I don't know if y'all really ever seen, like, how, like, the a game, like, in the 50s and 60s. Bro, the amount of turnovers that ridiculous, bro. The amount of turnovers is outrageous. It's outrageous how many turnovers they used to have. So the fact that Bob Cousy might have legitimate a 7 assists a game player who's turning the ball over like 5 times a game. And I'm supposed to. No, bro.
That's like Trae Young.
Yeah, but Trae Young without. Like, Trae Young without
the black. Trae Young, like, not gonna lie, if Bob Cousy saw me at 24 hour today, I'm giving him nightmares.
I mean, so serious. Y'all niggas could beat Bob Cousy.
I believe that. He see, like, me do a crossover, he gonna try to kill me.
He might. No, I'm not gonna say it. I'm not gonna say it. Yeah, y'all gotta get me. Y'all gotta get me out this act, because I was about to say something outrageous.
You
y'all
are crazy.
I was about to say something outrageous.
But were you gonna tell a lie?
Yo, save that for the court, bro.
Yeah. Let me
say, but were you finna tell a lie?
Discord. Let me say that for Discord. Let me try.
Hey,
y'all niggas got me feeling a little too comfortable in this fucking public setting. Yeah, we say that shit in private. Let me chill out.
Yeah, we'll talk about it later.
Yeah, no, that's crazy. Oh, fuck, bro. Oh, my goodness, because, jeez. Omar.
Is there another room?
Oh, he's not even here. He's still taking that test. Yo, let me see if I can get... I don't know if I can get any other people in here, though. This is tough. Let me see.
Yeah, and then his whole player build, like, come on, bro. Like, Bob Cousy for real.
It is. It's Bob Cousy for real, dog.
Yo, can you hear me?
Honestly, wait. I feel like he's racist. Mad Dog gotta be racist.
I actually think he low-key might be racist, too. That's tough.
Because, like, the things he just be saying is just like, bro, there's no way you could think that unless you're racist.
Nah, he just want, like, clout and shit.
Which is weird, though. Like, why choose clout through Bob Cousy propaganda?
At some point, though, we got to talk about ESPN letting him on. That might fall on ESPN more.
He's another Ryan Hollins, bro. Like, it's just a random.
No,
like,
he's way worse. Random stupid shit. No, he's way worse. Sure. I don't even think Ryan Hollins is that crazy. I mean, excuse me. I'm thinking about Ryan. The other Ryan. No, Ryan Hollins is crazy, but no, he's much worse than Ryan Hollins.
Hey man, Souls and Sage need some content. So
I ain't gonna lie, even I had to record to this nigga. No kizzy, bro. That nigga hurt, damn boy. Cause that nigga is tripping, boy. I ain't never in my life.
Look at Stephen A. For the first time, I saw KD rattled. Mm. Shut up, Stephen A. God.
Also, people act as if, like, Kevin Durant wasn't, like... People act as if, like, Kevin Durant wasn't, like, mid in the playoffs when he was in OKC. People keep acting like that version of him didn't exist.
You know what, bro? For one of the best ISO scores of all time, he needs so much spacing. It's crazy.
So much spacing. I can't take anything serious. We got two new people in here. Actually, we got three. I don't know. Y'all can just speak.
Yo.
Yo, what up? What up?
What's going on? What's going on?
Not much, dog.
I fuck with you, Low Legend Winning, you know. And I fuck with, you know, Sniper and y'all boys. It just that Bob Cousy. Bob Cousy, you still on the topic, right? Or you something else? Or no?
Oh, we can talk about anything at this point. It's because I don't think... I think some of y'all niggas might be stuck in this room, so we don't have to talk about Bob Cousy. I think some of y'all niggas might actually dead be stuck in this room until... Unless Omar closes it. Maybe if you close app. I don't know. It's kind of tough because I can't... Even when I see people trying to come up, it's hard for me to, like, accept them to come up. It's kind of hard to explain.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, you don't have to explain too much. But it's just that the fact that, like, you want to change the topic? You want to change the topic? My bad.
You can. It don't matter. We're just talking about...
Okay, anything. Like, I know this is cliche. You know, it's always back and forth. But it's just that, do you think LeBron is the greatest of all time between Jordan? Like, I know, it's cliche, man. It's just,
no, I don't. You know, I personally don't think so, no.
100%.
Oh, you believe it's Jordan? You believe it's Jordan?
Yeah, I believe it's Jordan, yeah.
Jordan's washed, man.
Washed.
Bro, that nigga is disgraceful. Don't even stop, man.
How is he disgraceful?
Bro, LeBron is just king, bro. Nah,
How is he disgraceful?
Gawk, bro.
The dick riding is wild.
Bro, you guys are old ass niggas. I'm probably young. That's probably why I freaking like
my... How old are you?
Yeah, how old are you, bro?
14.
But LeBron, I mean, Jordan made LeBron literally dead ass. Like,
you just started watching basketball.
Nah, you dragging.
You started with like 2018 LeBron.
Bro, I'm about to say you started with 2018 LeBron. Yo, you didn't even see the best version of that nigga.
God, the way he's dogging Terry Rozier is just, oh my god.
Hey, bro, you didn't see the best version of that nigga LeBron. That's tough, nigga.
Did you see Cleveland first time around?
Hey. I'm an ESPN analyst, man. So, you know, I study and shit. So,
Oh my God.
Well, you work on the lights?
Yeah, bro. I was even there when Bob Cousy was playing as well. And he's top five of all time.
Stop.
He really dogged Victor Oladipo.
Damn, what's the dude keeps bouncing in and out? He had his hands up. because he is somebody who left a comment on my tweet. He left and that stuff. To Shaba, the answer your question, I have Jordan greatest all time, bro.
Same out here. It's because like I feel like Jordan, like he just really changed the game, changed the motive and everything, like literally, bro. Like, and then like, you know, he basically made LeBron who he is. Like, you know, he motivated that nigga, bro. He basically shaped him, bro. Literally, man.
You don't think at some point the longevity is just gonna be like overwhelming in LeBron's favor?
To be honest, like even like I remember one time I was watching a video, a light clip, right? It was just Shaq and what's it called? Fuck, bro. When niggas just talking shit, bro. Fuck,
open
bro.
Court.
No. Somewhere like that, but
the shot.
You know. No.
Not the shot.
No. But look, they were just talking, right? One night. He was just saying, man, like as soon as like LeBron, you know, pass Kareem and points, he's like, everybody just shut up. Everybody just done deal. Quiet down. But it's just that like at the moment at hand, man, like think about it. Like Jordan was literally that nigga. He was a menace to society and basketball, bro. That's not even possible, man. Like yo, only nigga I ever seen it done it was Patrick Beverly, bro. Like
so, but to answer the longevity thing. Bro, I don't know what's going on. Uptown G's been like trying to come in for the past like this stuff. I don't even know that there's some legitimacy to that, and it would definitely make his argument much better. Just longevity. Is this what did you get accomplished within that time frame? And so, yes, statistically LeBron is going to look more dominant, but I mean honestly, okay. he's played more games, and on top of that, I mean. To his credit, I mean, he's played in systems where it allowed him to just do more statistically. Once Jordan was into the triangle offense, like he's not able to average 7-8 assists anymore. Like that's just out of the realm of possibility.
True.
Yo, quick question.
Yeah, what up?
Yo, how much of y'all that's speaking right now think Jordan's the GOAT?
I mean, I do.
I do right now.
Nah, no, of course.
I do. And let me say something real quick. Longevity go out the window, like Legend said, when you've done less and more time. So, like, the longevity factor is low-key out the window. I mean, it looks nice and shit, but when you actually start breaking shit down, you can see what it is for real.
Wait, so do y'all y'all think can LeBron do anything else to make himself the GOAT by the end of his career done, or is it just like
if he win a ring with Westbrook? If that nigga won this year, I would give it to him. I'm like, you got.